Welcome everyone to Police Quest 1 in Pursuit of the Death Angel. I'm your host, Lostwolfe, and last week we came out here, we talked to Mari. Mari told us that she would help us with the operation in Hotel Delphoria. So now we're going to go back and we're going to report our success to Lieutenant Morgan. I believe we've got a gun, but I don't remember. Oh, yes, I do. Okay. Get into car. Close the door. And one day it will save me. Okay, so episode 9. I hope everyone's had a good week. As always, mine has been pretty relaxing. We're gonna drive upwards to our friend, the station. I'm on the wrong side of the road. It's gonna get me killed. Yeah, as I was saying, I've been having a pretty relaxed week. We had a friend of my mom's out for... just because she could come down. And, that was pretty pleasant. Ooh. Your radio crackles. 83 Nora 10. Respond to Cotton Cove. Officers on scene need ID of 187 victim. Okay, let's go do that. We are so close to being at our office. But oh well. These things happen. We're police officers. So yeah, she came out for a couple of days just to be with my mom and to hang out. And that was quite pleasant. I don't want to die. I'd better save, right? In case people are wondering why I keep driving on the wrong side of the road, it's because of where I live. And I'm just not used to this whole driving on the right-hand side of the road thing. Please don't thank you. And we will park. Okay. Looks pretty scary. Open door. And close the door. I suppose we should radio on in. You radio in. Dispatch 83 Nora 10, 1097 Cotton Cove. Your radio crackles 10-4, 83 Nora 10, dispatch copies 1097 Cotton Cove. I believe he's just saying that I'm there, but we'll see. Good to see you, Sonny, he says. We've got a ripe on here with no ID. Is this the dude you arrested? Since you're the guy who booked him, we hope you can identify him. Well, let's take a look. Hold on, before we do. The two marked patrol cars with emergency lights flashing and the covered body in a clearing clouds the natural beauty of the Cotton Cove. Look, man. The policemen stand near a dead body. Look, police man. Oh, great. Okay, so it's not going to tell us who these people are. Okay. Look, body. The body's covered by a blanket. Blanket. You lift the white blanket and examine the swollen body. It resembles Jason Taselli. However, you can't be sure. Let's lift his shirt. Oh. Open shirt. The soggy shirt peels slowly from his chest. Above his left nipple, you spot the flower tattoo, which confirms your identification. That's the man. It's radio in. You key the radio. Dispatch. This is 83 Nora 10. Report positive ID on body of one Jason Selly. 10-8 Cotton Cove. Your radio cackles. 10-4 83 Nora 10. Dispatch copies. 10-22 APB Jason Selly. I believe they're saying that they're going to stop the APB. APB is All Points Bulletin. It means they're chasing after him. Thanks, Sonny. Be advised. Coroner's en route. 1019 per Lieutenant Morgan. Okay, now I believe that that means that we are going to head on back. Cover. Close shirt. Gladly. Okay. The body's covered by a blanket. Yeah, it is already. Anyhow. Talk to man. Thanks for your help, Sonny, says Steve. Oh, that was Steve. Okay, well, the guy's yellow hair, he must be Steve. Okay, why is he following me, though? So creepy. Okay, open door, get into car. Animal fasten, seatbelt. And we'll derve. Oh, good lord. Look at this mess. Hold on now. Episode 9. After Cove. I believe that was all I needed to do. Yes, it is. Okay. But just in case it's not. Right, so let's head on back to the station. So we can get moving on our other plan for today. Which is that we're going to start off into the hotel operation. Which is a whole big mess of things that we need to do. I hope I get that, thank you, before the light changes. Otherwise, it's been pretty quiet for me. I have been doing a little more Java. I have been, I marked some of my stuff for work, marked down some of my stuff for work, and mostly I've just been relaxing, so we're going to park the car and save. Open. Oh, that's not open door at all. Okay. So, let's go talk to our friend Lieutenant Morgan. Okay. In we go. Oh goodness. Okay. Okay, we got Lauren, yeah, we've got Marie as well. Sonny, step on over to my desk. I have devised a plan to infiltrate the gambling scene at the Hotel Delphoria, Lieutenant Morgan begins. Sure. Sonny, I want you to check into the hotel under the name of Jimmy Lee Bankston. He continues. Meet Sweet Cheeks in the hotel cocktail lounge. Okay. Signal Sweet Cheeks that you're ready to begin the operation by ordering a drink. She'll pretend to recognize you as Whitey, an old friend recently released from prison. She'll introduce you to bartender Woody Roberts, whom we believe is the contact man for the backroom hustle. You'll be carrying a large sum of money in marked bills, of course, and will pretend to be eager for action. All right. Lieutenant Morgan concludes, since Laura developed your disguise, I'll let her fill you in on its details. Sonny, I've picked out a white suit for you, Laura says, and by the way, we've decided your hair must be bleached. Well, she did, or he did say that I'm whitey, so. You'll walk with the aid of this special cane. Its handle is really a detachable 22 caliber Magnum Derringer, when the need arises, you'll carry a voice transmitter disguised as a plain-looking ballpoint pen. Goodness gracious, this is all very James Bond. Laura adds, I picked up these supplies at the beauty shop. Take this bottle of bleach cream activator into the shower and bleach your hair. Okay. That's all I have, concludes Laura. Sweet Jeeks, do you have anything to add? In an excited... Oh, dear. In an excited voice, Sweet Cheeks says, Oh, Sonny, I'm so happy I get to work with you. Why, it's almost bringing a tear to my eye. It almost brings a tear to my eye. I'm looking forward to spending tonight working with you at the Hotel Delphoria. My precious... She winks at you. Oh, dear. Sweet Cheeks, says Lieutenant Morgan. Why don't you head on over to the hotel? Sonny will follow you shortly. I think that's a good plan. Thanks for your help, Laura, Morgan says. That's all for now. And off Laura goes. Goodness. Very James Bond. Lieutenant Morgan instructs you, Sonny, after you bleach your hair and change clothes, report back to me. I have more instructions for you. Okay. Sounds super awesome. Okay. Sergeant Dooley, his voice cracking, interrupts the meeting. It is my regretful duty to inform you that I've just received a phone call from Jack Cobb. His daughter, Kathy, just died without ever regaining consciousness. Whoops! Okay, forget what I said a couple of episodes ago. Effective immediately, Jack is on extended family leave. Jack's taking this really hard. His brother is staying with him, and he requests no visitors. I'm sure our sympathy goes out to Jack in his time of need. Yeah, indeed. Poor guy. Hatred wells up inside of you. You vow revenge for Kathy's senseless death by tracking down the dope-balled animals responsible. Lieutenant Morgan speaks softly. Sonny, the sooner you get into the scene at the Hotel Delphoria, the sooner we can neutralize those bloodsuckers. Alright, so off we go. We're gonna head on over to the cleaning locker, well, our locker, because we're gonna do something that the game actually requires from us. I'm gonna put down the radio for now. You return your radio extender to the recharge stand. I think I still need the keys for the car. They haven't told me that I'm going to change cars, so I believe so. Okay. This is our one and only real compulsory shower. So let's go take it. Get towel. Regulations require a shower before changing. Right, that's fine. And we got a new suit. A white suit, in fact. Let's see if we can look at the suit. Your NPD uniform is hanging neatly on a hanger. Your civilian clothes are hanging on a hanger. An old t-shirt and a pair of jeans hang here. Your new white pump suit. Really? Okay. It's hanging on a hanger. Awesome. It's a pump suit. I got the Litton Tribune with me and the keys. I'm going to go and shower with them. Seems good. Alright. Let's look at the bleach. Dance Miracle Blonde. Just wet and rinse. That's what we'll do. Turn on shower. There's nothing like a nice hot shower. Wet hair. Good idea. Okay. You carefully pour the bleach on your hair. Now what? Good idea. With great anticipation, you carefully rinse the bleach from your hair. At last, you'll find out if blondes really have more fun. And... typing is difficult today. Alright, I believe that's it for us. Let's... Oh, okay. It's very difficult to see, but the bleach was sitting on the edge of the shower whenever I got into the shower. And I thought I might have to retrieve the bleach. But evidently it's used up and it's gone, so... Open door. And... Get clothes. Right. I don't believe that I need anything else. How wonderful! 15 years of service have come to this. Wearing a pimp suit to meet a hooker. Now that's professional advancement. Wouldn't your mommy be proud? Oh dear. Let's see what the janitor has to say. Woo-wee! Looks what we got here, laughs Jefferson. Oh, Jefferson. I'm glad you find this all so amusing. We are gonna head back to Lieutenant Morgan because that's what he wanted us to do. Oh, it's... Oh, the things this game makes me do. Right. In we go. Come over to my desk. I have some things to discuss with you. After you infiltrate the illegal gambling activities at the hotel, contact me. I'll send over a team of detectives to serve as your backups. Okay, cool. This envelope contains $1,000 marked $100 bills. In marked $100 bills. Use your head, Sonny, and don't forget, we want Mr. Big. You want the band? But they're terrible, and they don't come out for several years. Just then, the office intercom squelches. Lieutenant Morgan, Homicide Detective Oscar Hamilton, on line 3. You patiently wait while Morgan grumbles on the phone. When the conversation ends, Morgan relates to Hamilton's comments on the floater found in this morning at Cotton Cove. Sonny, it seems that Hoffman Taselli was shot execution style before he decided to take his little swim. It looks like you're walking right into the dragon's lair at the Hotel Delphoria. Be careful, boy. Yeah, we'll do that. Well, that's it here, Morgan says. Now, let's go meet Sweet Cheeks and get this campaign rolling. Sounds good. But first, we need your phone number. 555-6674. We need that number. Because what's going to happen is that this is the land before time. There's no cell phones. We need that number because we need to be able to phone him when we're in an established hotel before you. Okay. Right, I'm going to go do that. There's one other thing that I want to do just before I call it an episode. And that is that I want to call Jack and I want to convey my sympathies. So, hold on a second. Look in tray. Hey, it's empty. Good stuff. Okay. Hey, I thought you were supposed to go to the Hotel Delphoria. Yeah, I am. Don't worry. I'm going to do that now. What? I don't want to go. Pick up the phone. Use phone. I want to dial Jack's number, and that would be that number. Cobb residents, you offer your condolences to the Cobb family. Thank you so much, Sonny. And that's about it. That's all I want to do. I shall see you in the next episode. Hey! Yes, I am. Don't worry. I shall see you... Let me just get out to the car park. And then I'll save there. But I shall see you all next week when we hit the Hotel Delphoria itself. And we start checking out what's going on there. We're going to do our safety check very quickly, just so I don't have to do that at the start of the episode. And hopefully the car will check out okay. There we go, walking around. I'm just walking around. Yeah, I totally am. Okay, safety check done. Right, I will see everyone next week when we hit the Hotel Delphoria, and maybe we make some headway into what's going on here. I've been Lostwolfe, this is Police Quest 1 in Pursuit of the Death Angel. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope everyone has an excellent week. Bye-bye for now.